Hey guys, it's Marlene. There's a new firmware update for the Lumix G9 and a couple of other Lumix cameras, and it includes a new feature called Focus Ring Control. I have instructions on how to update your firmware later in this video, but first I'm going to show you what Focus Ring Control is and how to set it up. Focus Ring Control works in manual focus mode. It's most suitable when shooting video. You go into your menus, and you go into the tools, and you go to page 7 of 8, Focus Ring Control. And you have two settings here. You have non-linear and linear. I'm going to start with linear first. I'm going to choose set, and I'm going to choose a distance that I move my focus rings. 90 degrees means that from the closest to the farthest is 90 degrees on the focus ring. If I start at the top of the focus ring and I move a quarter of the way around, that's 90 degrees. And if I move halfway around, that's 180 degrees. And that's what those numbers mean. So why would you use this? Well, this is useful for video. So let me just show you here. Let's just get into focus. My peaking is on. So what peaking means is that the areas that are colored are in focus. If you don't have it enabled, you have to go into your menus, go into the tools, and choose Monitor Display, and that will bring you to page 5 of 8, and you'll see the peaking there. Make sure that it's turned on, and just so you know, you can also change the color of the peaking. Right now I have it on green, but you can change it to any of these colors. You can also change it to high or low sensitivity. I just leave mine on high. So here's my peaking on the little froggy, and when I turn it, you can see that the peaking is on in the background. And that's Jane Jacobs, in case you're wondering. So here we go, frog, background, okay, far, near. Of course, I'm not using the full distance from the closest to the farthest, so I don't move my focus ring very much. If I change it to 180, for example, so twice as much. So what that means is it takes a little bit more distance on the focus ring to go from one subject to the other. It takes a little bit longer to change that. And that means if you're pulling focus from, say, a two shot with two people in a scene or a person in a background, it takes longer and you get a smoother focus pull from back to front, front to back. If you have a smaller angle, you have a much shorter distance for focus pulling and it goes much quicker. So if you want a snappy focus pull, you definitely want to choose like 90 degrees. Okay, what about nonlinear? Well, let's go back into the focus ring control settings. Go to nonlinear, and you can see here that focus responds according to the rotation speed of the focus ring. So now when we focus, if we turn the focus ring quickly, it'll snap into focus quickly. If we turn it slowly though, you can see that the focus ring has to travel a lot more distance for me to get it into focus. In fact, I've already gone 180 and almost 360 degrees around. If I do it quickly, it snaps to the frog. Went too fast there. So forward, forward, back, forward, back. So it's less accurate, I find. But if you want a really slow focus pull, you can do that. So personally, I prefer using linear with a short angle of control. I think if I wanted a slower focus pull, I would just choose a larger angle. If you have any questions, let me know in the comments below. And if this little froggy and Jane Jacobs have helped you, please buy me a coffee. I appreciate all of you who've bought me coffee so far, and we'll see you in the next video. Here's how to install the firmware update in the Lumix G9. I have all the links you need in the video description below. Go to the page where the firmware updates are located and find your camera and click to download. You can see the release notes for this firmware update, and you can see that it also has updates for the DJI Ronin. You have to accept the terms and conditions, and it will start to download to your computer. And it takes a couple of minutes. When you're done, extract the zip file or the exe file, and you get a bin file, B-I-N. Copy that bin file to a memory card that is clean and formatted. I keep a separate memory card just for firmware updates. Okay, and you can see that the bin file is copied to the memory card. Now, if you get lost in this procedure, Panasonic has this whole procedure outlined as well right off that downloads page, so you can read that for yourself if my instructions don't make sense. Right now, I'm on version 2.4 on my camera, and I want to do an update. Start with your camera off and insert the memory card with the bin file on it. And I take out my other memory cards as well. I just want the one in there. Turn your camera on, hit the playback button, and it will automatically start the versioning up. And so you say yes, and it takes a couple of minutes to do that. I'll just speed the video up a bit. When it's done, the camera shuts off, restarts, and then you can go back into your menu and check what version you're on, and it should have the next version. So in this case, 2.5. Like I said, if you get lost, Panasonic has very detailed instructions about how to do this. The biggest mistake people make is they don't copy the right file to their memory card, and they don't hit the playback button when they put that memory card into their camera.